Hey guys, I was thinking it might be a little helpful to give you some added insight into how I score my movie reviews. Everyone's scale is different. Movie reviews aren't fact, they're personal, so I wanted to let you guys know where I'm coming from. First, my scale. Here's how I break it down. An A is a 10, an F is a 1, and then in the middle, a 6 equates to a B minus, and a C plus equates to a 5, and that's where we get that Rotten Tomatoes divide. A 6 is fresh, but a 5.9 is considered rotten, where in my mind, a 6 is something that I would just recommend. So now that we've got the numbers and the letters laid out, what goes into choosing one of those scores? And there's no clear-cut answer to that. It changes from film to film. I go into everything I see with an open mind, but personal taste does come into play. I consider technical achievements, rewatchability, how much the film moved me. It can really be anything. And what that means is sometimes maybe I won't enjoy something, but I'll be so impressed by the atmosphere and the world building that I'll give it more credit for that. And other times I see story flaws, but I had so much fun watching a movie that the entertainment value gives it a big boost. I think it's also important to highlight the difference between best and favorite, especially with those end of the year lists coming up real fast. When I grade a movie in an individual review, all the aforementioned factors come into play. It's story, characters, visuals, emotional response, and then some. However, when I'm doing my favorite films of the year, it's based on a deeply personal response. It's a difficult thing to explain, but just to throw out a few examples, my top 10 does tend to be populated with movies I can't stop watching or ones I had an extreme emotional response to. It's not necessarily the movies that I gave the highest scores to, though. For example, La La Land was my favorite movie of 2016. Did I give it a 10 out of 10? Nope. Am I able to identify some flaws in it? Yes, I am. But I still think it's exceptional filmmaking on many levels. It moved me to tears and it inspired me. And as for that 10 out of 10 score goes, you've probably noticed that I rarely give one. And it's true, 10 out of 10 is a perfect score and I don't take that lightly. So I only give that rating to a very, very select few. So I hope this gives you a little bit of a clearer sense of my personal process when scoring movies. Clearly, it's fluid to a degree. Everyone's got different tastes, different preferences, different reviewing scales, and I'm a firm believer that that's a big reason this industry is so exciting and special. Different opinions inspire conversation, diversity in filmmaking. They challenge you to consider something you might not have before. We don't all have to agree, and you most certainly don't have to share my opinion, but I will respect your thoughts. I hope you can respect mine, and what I can promise you right now is that you will always get my honest opinion on the movies I see, no matter what. So, thank you guys so much for watching. See you soon.